Remember that night when I cried in the garden? I knew back then I would die a martyr. Don't lie, it's harder. I said right then you would turn on me. Still concerned for you, but no concern for me. Let me burn this piece, go and cross my heart for eternity. What up?
Still I'm overthinking this life. I try. Give my all, but I can't win in this fight. I don't know why.
Whoever sees this and subscribes right now will get a free epiphany. Don't worry, it'll just come to you. What's going on, YouTube? It's Noxhill, and we're back with our reaction series. So today, you know I read the comments. The good, the bad, the ugly, the trolls. And you guys have been requesting that we get back on board this Eminem train and jump into his new album, Music to be Murdered By, the B-side. So today's something we're going to do comes off of high recommendation from you guys. It is called Killer. I've seen so many comments and requests for it. Thank you guys for your patience while I recharge for the holidays. But we are back on this M train now. We're going to start cranking through the rest of this album. We are going to get through it. So stay tuned for that. We got a lot more to do. Also, a quick note on the song in the intro. If you guys like that, I have a brand new album that is out now. 20 tracks. It is called Chaos Theory. Blood, sweat, tears, heart, and soul put into that. If you like lyrical rap, rap with substance, I'm trying to help keep it alive, man. I'm an independent artist, so you want to support me and support the channel directly, I encourage you to check that out below. But anyways, the master is back up again. Eminem, step up to the plate. Let's see what you got.
Yeah. It's crazy. I made all this money from doing this.
I don't know why. I was thinking about some type of tribal ceremony. You know, like the big Hawaiian heads, like bump, 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 bump. DA got the dope, man. He has been on quite a few tracks on this album now. He was on Godzilla. He was on Nat. So he's been on the two flagship music video tracks. Yeah, he's a good producer, man. So you hear his tag in the beginning. But what's interesting about this and what caught my ears immediately, one, the instrumentation was guided by vocals. Taking a vocal sound and turning that into instrumentation. And that is guiding the track currently. That was cool. So you had a little bit of bass kicking. And then you had the bump, bump. And I think there was more vocals to it. Let's check it out.
Yeah. It's crazy.
That's wild. No, it's just those vocals, the bump, bump. So it like hits here. And then almost it gets like reverbed and echoed out. And it hits even further to the sides of the headphones. You can hear it. It goes like bump, 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 bump. Check this out, people. Time to invest in some new headphones for Christmas, man, with that money you got.
Yeah. It's crazy.
That's cool.
Made all this money from doing this. Now count it by 10.
Woo.
Yeah, 15, 20, 25, 30. Yeah, get the money. Throw it in the furnace. Yeah, this shit be funny. Earn it just to burn it. Swag dripping from me. That's what I do with me.
Hey, now count it. He's counting out the money, man. He's like making it rain. But then he says, earn it just to burn it. E-A-R-N, but also is in an urn, burning it like a funeral urn. U-R-N, A, just casual wordplay that he threw into the hook. And then adding more vocals to instrumentation. This is really cool, guys. I know I'm getting hung up on this, but this is dope as hell. There's another vocal sample that we've used to add tempo and add pace to this beat. Check this out.
10, yeah, 15, 20, 25, 30.
Whatever that. It's hitting at different size of the headphones, man. That's wild.
Yeah, get the money, throw it in the furnace. Yeah, this shit be funny.
And then someone's singing too. Someone's just singing like harmonies and ad libs. Like, I can't sing. Don't even do it, Knox. Don't embarrass yourself today. So that's three different types of vocals that are happening to guide this track. You have percussion kicking, you have bass, and that's it. The rest of the harmonizing, of changing sort of the tune, and the tempo is being guided by different vocal samples all over the mix. That's a wild concept, man. That's so cool.
25, 30, yeah, get the money, throw it in the furnace. Yeah, this shit be funny.
That's singing.
Just to burn it, swag dripping from me. That's what I do with money. Got money off the ass, call it toilet paper. Yeah, flush with cash.
Yo, I just realized that he's saying killer. The track is called Killer, right? Killer. And was that him in the back of the mix that did that killer? That was pretty good singing from him if it was. I thought it was someone else on the sample, but it might be him. All right, now we got actual bars and lyrics to break down. Hold up.
Furnace. Yeah, this shit be funny. Earn it just to burn it. Swag dripping from me. That's what I do with money. Got money
killer.
Up the ass. Call it toilet paper. Yeah, flush with
got money up the ass. Call it toilet paper. And then he says, flush? Hang on. I stopped it too soon.
From me, that's what I do with money. Got money off the ass, call it toilet paper. Yeah, flush with cash, girl, nice butt.
All right, so you know the saying, like, I got money at the ass, like, I got a ton of money. But also, like, he is flush with cash. He has so much cash. But then relating to the toilet paper scheme, like flushing it when you're on the toilet, he's flushing it because it's coming out of his rear end. That's a beautiful picture right there, people. That is poetry that you play to your significant other when you really want to impress her.
Money, got money off the ass, call it toilet paper. Yeah, flush with cash, girl, nice butt. Is it up for grabs? Just want to touch your ass. Is that too much to ask?
Up for grabs. Touch your ass. Much to ask. Three-syllable rhymes, right? That's a multi-syllable rhyme scheme. And that is simple to Eminem. That's a simple scheme. But there's a lot of, like, mumble rappers that can't even do that. They can't just casually throw in these three-syllable rhyme schemes that he's doing right now, that he's chopping it up with. Simple to M. I mean, we know he can go 4, 5, 6. He can do whole lines if he wants. I love this sort of just bounce and this vibe to him, man. Again, this is a change of pace on the album. This is a different style of track. It's cool.
Girl, nice butt. Is it up for grabs? Just want to touch your ass. Is that too much to ask? Yeah, I made a grip. I know it's tough to grasp. Get the bag, call it potato chips. I stuff and dope.
No, he didn't. I made a grip. I know it's tough to grasp. A grip, like a grip of money, like a hundo. 100,000 in cash. He's making stacks, basically, is what he's saying. But also playing off a grip, when you grip something, you grasp it. I know it's tough to grasp how much money that I have. Nice double.
Must to ask? Yeah, I made a grip. I know it's tough to grasp. Get the bag, call it potato chips. I stuff in duffel bags on some public transportation shit.
Call it potato chips. I get the bag. When you get the bag, you're getting money. But also potato chips come in a bag. He stuffs them in duffel bags, but also he's talked about money, like stacking chips is another way of saying money. So he's basically just on this crazy money metaphor right now.
I know it's tough to grasp, get the bag, call it potato chips. I stuff in duffel bags on some public transportation shit, because I will bust your ass, fuck the chain, I'm off the trailer.
Public transportation shit, because I will bust your ass. The way he said it, he didn't hold that T, right? So it can be taken as bus, like a bus is public transportation. And what do? You sit on your ass on a bus, so a bus buses you around. But also, like, he will bust, B-U-S-T. He will bust your ass. And I also take that kind of as a triple, because if you work in public transportation, like, it's not a very gratifying industry. You're not making a lot normally. You're busting your ass working on that job.
Chips, I stuff in duffel bags on some public transportation shit, because I will bust your ass. Fuck the chain, I'm off the trailer hitch. I got a bunch of swag, now count it by 10.
Fuck the chain, I'm off the trailer hitch. You know, you use a chain to help make sure that the trailer hitch is secure. Also, Eminem is from 8 Mile. He's from the trailer park, baby. Right? So he's off the trailer. He's going crazy on this track. The trailer hitch. So that's a double. And then I also kind of take it as, no. That's a triple. We got a triple called here. The chain. There's a saying, being off the chain, right? Like being sick with it. But also, like a chain. Like wearing a chain. And what is this song? What is the hook of this song? Talking about burning the money. Earn it just to burn it. So he's saying, fuck the chains. I don't need the chain. I'm bragging about all this wealth and stuff, but I don't have to show it off, right? Because again, I'm from the trailer park. I'm from the bottom. I know what it means to have nothing. I'm going to brag. I'm going to talk about what I got. But do you see him in designer clothes? No. He just dresses like an everyday dude, man. He's like the Bill Belichick of rapping when he gets out there and does his music videos.
Tation shit, cause I will bust your ass. Fuck the chain, I'm off the trailer hitch. I got a bunch of swag. Now count it by 10. Yeah, 15, 20, 25.
Oh. I just love how that's hitting in different sides of the headphones. I can't get over, man. This whole beat is being driven by vocals, like beatboxing style, man. This is cool.
Off the trailer hitch, I got a bunch of swag. Now count it by 10. Yeah, 15, 20.
All over.
25, 30. Yeah, get the money. Throw it in the furnace. Yeah, this shit be funny. Earn it just to burn it. Swag dripping from me. Yeah, I'm a.
This is good hook.
Yeah. I'm a.
Oh, we just introduced a little bit of strings into the instrumentation just to mix it up in terms of the production. Still being driven, bass, drums, and vocals. And then right there towards the end when he's doing the killers. And I love the harmony that he hits on that. You just have a little bit of the strings coming in the back too.
I'm a.
Right there.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. My income is all that and then some. Your man is an income poop, a symptom of a symptom.
Income, ninkum. Think about how he chops up words. He's so good at taking a word, and it's like he just dissects it, man. Like, he gets the lyrical knife out, and he just figures out how he can bend it and just enunciate a certain part of it to make it rhyme with another part, and then continue off that phrase in that sentence. It's so good.
Income is all that and then some. Girl, your man is an income poop, a symptom of a simp, because you spend some loot to get some.
Is he a symptom? Hang on, I didn't catch that.
Some girl, your man is an income poop, a symptom of a simp, because you spend some loot to get some.
All right, he's a symptom of a simp. A symptom of a simp. Right, okay, so your man is a simp. Why is he a simp? I'm sure Eminem's gonna tell us.
Girl, your man is an income poop, a symptom of a simp, because he'll spend some loot to get some. As for me, I'm the Kim Jong.
Because he'll spend some loot to get some. Right, because a simp, like simps for girls, will do anything for attention from a girl. Like, give them money, you know, like, go on that Twitch stream, donate all that money, look at me, give me that attention. So, thinking that they'll try to get some, that's what he's saying. But also, he's still relating it to the whole money scheme. And he's just, you know what's cool about this? Is that he is doing what a lot of rappers in the mainstream do. Brag about their wealth. Brag about their level of income. But because M is taking something that everyone does, he's doing it in his unique Eminem way. With his doubles and his triples. With this production, which is so unique. You know, with his delivery, with his schemes. If you're going to do the same shit that everyone else does, this is what I say, then do it differently. Do it in a different way. Show that you can do it better than everyone else. Or show that you can do it from a different type of concept. And that's what's happening here.
I'm poop, a symptom of a simp, to spend some loot to get some. As for me, I'm the Kim Jong-un, a pimp's hunt.
Also, my brain is going, guys. I don't know what is wrong with me today. But did I talk about spending some to get some in terms of money as well? So it's not just spending some like to get some ass. Sexually being a simp, but also spending some money to get some. He'll spend anything. He'll go like involve himself in any sort of Ponzi scheme. He's so desperate for money just to get some. And then M is the Kim Jong. We doing some North Korea shit now, M? Hold up.
Spend some loot to get some. As for me, I'm the Kim Jong Un of pimps, hun.
Oh my God, the Kim Jong Un of pimps, hun. Right? So he's a dictator, right? He is the most powerful man in North Korea, Kim Jong Un. Right? So what he's saying here is that, you know, hey, he can have anyone that he wants. He's just in control. There is no one above him. You know, he's controlling these girls. OM.
Of a simp, cause he'll spend some loot to get some. As for me, I'm the Kim Jong-un, a pimp's hun. Swag dripping, I'm in a pub. Went up to this chick who was so tipsy. We went to hug. Ended up tripping. I picked her up. She yelled out, it's a birthday. She's 50.
She's so tipsy. They go to hug. And she trips, get it? Being tipsy, like tripping. She's tripping out. She's really drunk. She may have been walking, staggered, and then she tripped into him. Then they hugged. And then, do we have a 50 Cent shout out? I think we do.
Tipsy, we went to hug. Ended up tripping. Picked her up. She yelled out, it's a birthday. She's 50 and in the club. Then it comes on. Yeah.
That's dope. That's dope. See, it was coming in. It's her birthday. And it just makes me think because it's so iconic. It's hammered into my brain. Go, 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 shorty. It's your birthday. We gonna party like it's your birthday. We gonna sip a Cardi like it's your birthday. And you know we don't give a fuck that it's your birthday. You can find me in the club. 50 Cent's infamous song. So she's 50, like she's turning 50. But also she's 50 like 50 Cent in the club. And I swear to you, I think we have an ad-lib metaphor going on here. Because you have 50 Cent's go, go. Go. That starts off in the club in the background. Hold up.
Picked her up. She yelled out, it's a birthday. She's 50 and in the club.
It was. I heard the goes. That's so cool.
Picked her up. She yelled out, it's a birthday. She's 50 and in the club. Then it comes on. Yeah. That in the club song. Yeah. She's a buzzsaw. What? We're going numbskull.
On the edge. She's a buzzsaw. We're going numbskull. Buzzsaw, numbskull. You get that reference. But also a buzzsaw is if, like, she's buzzing off the alcohol right now.
Yeah. That in the club song. Yeah. She's a buzzsaw. What? We're going numbskull. I live on the edge. She's a jump off. Yeah. Call her Cinderella. Why?
No. I live on the edge. Because when you're on the edge, there is a little bit of that temptation to jump, you know, to just want to fly. But a jump off is a chick that gives it up very easily. Like, you don't date a jump off, right? You just one night stand a jump off is what he's saying here.
Going numbskull, I live on the edge. She's a jump off. Mm. Yeah. Call her Cinderella. Why? She loves balls. Now count it by.
Why do you do this? Why do you do this? Why do you take my childhood and ruin it, Eminem? Taking Cinderella. Cinderella going to the ball, the glass slipper. But she loves balls. She loves M's balls. Why did he put that picture in my head?
On the edge, she's a jump off. Yeah. Call her Cinderella. Why? She loves balls. Now count it 5-10. Yeah, 15-20. 25-30. Yeah, get the money. Throw it in the furnace. Yeah, this shit be funny. Earn it just to burn it. Swag tripping from me. Yeah. Attack like the Ripper. All over the track.
Whoa, that was cool. Instead of holding out the killer, he just comes right back in this time. And I've been thinking, man, these first two verses are short. I just wanted to check what length we're in on this. So we still got a good chunk of the song left. What? One thing that I've noticed is that he goes like 1-2, and I think that my mind's all right. Then that third verse, for some reason, on a few songs on this album, he just comes crazy with it. I'm just wondering if he's going to do that again, if this is going to be longer, because his song structure is sort of different. It's not like we're doing like 16 bars, 16 bars, 16 bars. I think the first one was like 8. It was like 8-8. And then what's this going to be? No way there's going to be 8 if that much of the song is left, unless we have like 4 verses.
Just to burn it, swag tripping from me. Attack like the Ripper, all over the track, doing laps like a strip.
Attack like the Ripper, he's a killer. Jack the Ripper was a killer. Nice way to play off of his own hook. That's dope.
Tripping from me, attack like the Ripper, all over the track, doing laps like a stripper. Now.
All over the track, doing laps like a stripper. He's out rapping you. He's running laps around you on this musical track. Also, what do you do on a track? You run laps around the track. What does a stripper do? Well, she does lap dances for money. So she's lap dancing, but also she's on laps as well, because she's a stripper. That's a casual triple that M just did.
Attack like the Ripper, all over the track, doing laps like a stripper. Now. Wow, look out, ow, rap circles around, round clowns around, sound, sound. John Ram.
That's so cool. He went left to right, playing off of the stereo sound, doing surround sound. Hang on, because he's wrapping circles around you. Get it? Like he's running around you, almost like I picture him just running circles around the audio right now. And then the surround sound. It is surround sound going left to right on the stereo. That's dope. John Rambo's back. I can't do it as well because my voice is hoarse today, but he just dropped down. And I love this sort of like lazy flow switch. It's like just a casual delivery, a little bit behind the beat this time.
John Rambo's back and my ammo stacked and I'm cocking raps. I'm on your head.
My ammo stacked, I'm cocking raps. You hear that? That's a cool little cadence change.
John Rambo's back and my ammo stacked and I'm cocking raps. I'm on your head. Other words, I'm stocking caps and I'm talking fast.
In other words, I'm stocking caps. And did you hear him go, ch-ch? Because a cap, like, I'll bust a cap in your ass like a gun. Like, a cap on your head. So he'll cap you lyrically with these bullets. Also, a stocking cap, like you wear on your head. I don't need to wear a stocking cap. I have very beautiful hair. I'm also white, so it's not normally something that white people wear. But some people do. Eminem rocks a stocking cap sometimes, man. I like those lines.
Stacked and I'm cocking raps, I'm on your head. Other words, I'm stocking caps and I'm talking facts.
Oh, he's stocking caps, like he's got the ammunition, like he's got it in stock. But also, I picture Rambo, man, because Rambo used to wrap that bandana around his head, didn't he? So that plays off of that, at your head, like he's at your head, man. He's coming for your head right now. And Rambo, shout out to Rambo, man. Sylvester Stallone.
Stacked and I'm cocking raps, I'm on your head. Other words, I'm stocking caps and I'm talking.
Coronavirus, if I cough one more time.
Ammo stacked and I'm cocking raps, I'm on your head. Other words, I'm stocking caps and I'm talking facts like Office Max. Never down, I'll be up like an insomnia.
I'm talking facts like Office Max. F-A-X, as in sending a fax. Some of you might never have sent a fax in your life now because we have a new generation. But also, he's talking facts. F-A-C-T-S. Like, these are just straight facts what he's doing.
I'm stocking caps and I'm talking facts like Office Max. Never down, I'll be up like an insomniac girl. Like,
ooh, how about that just little record spin right there and then total beat switch. Let's go.
Caps and I'm talking facts like Office Max. Never down, I'll be up like an insomniac girl. I got racks, you got a rack.
Never down, I'll be up like an insomniac, because an insomniac can't sleep, is always up, But he's always up. M is always up. He's winning, basically.
Talking facts like office smacks. Never down. I'll be up like an insomniac. Girl, I got racks. You got a rack. How you got all that back?
I got racks. You got a rack. Like saying a girl has a nice rack. All right. She's got a nice pair on her. But also like racks. Eminem stacking racks on racks in terms of money.
Like office smacks. Never down. I'll be up like an insomniac. Girl, I got racks. You got a rack. How you got all that back? And nobody fat. I'm in awe with that.
Oh, my God. Also, a rack, like a coat rack, because I be up. What do? You hang a coat up. Hang clothes up on a rack. No, he didn't. No, he
down,
didn't.
I'll be up like an insomniac, girl. I got racks, you got a rack. How you got all that back and nobody fat? I'm in awe with that when I stopped the Pontiac at the laundromat that I saw.
How you got all that back and nobody fat? Hey, I like how he put that. He's basically saying, girl, I know you got some surgery done. All right, because that is just, something is not adding up right there in terms of how your figure is. That's all right, though. That's all right, though, because he's bragging about wealth again. And as you find, like a lot of celebrities, they tend to get, you know, a lot of jobs done. People that have money get a lot of plastic surgery. It does happen. So M still sticking with the money theme and what he's got and the type of woman who would be attracted to him and his money. Hey, he's looking for gold diggers.
And I'm talking facts like office smacks. Never down, I'll be up like an insomniac. Girl, I got racks, you got a rack. How you got all that back and nobody fat? I'm in awe with that when I stopped the Pontiac at the laundromat that I saw you at. You almost had a heart attack when in the cardiac. You ran inside, told your boyfriend like I'll be back before.
Almost had a cardiac, almost had a heart attack when he pulled up in the Pontiac. All right, yeah, because she's a gold digger, all right?
That I saw you at, you almost had a heart attack. Went in the cardiac, you ran inside. Told your boyfriend, like, I'll be back. But for all you know, I probably act like I'm Daniel Wozniak. I'm a psychopathic killer. I'm a caterpillar with the botanica.
I'm a psychopathic killer. Psychopath killer. That was a Slaughterhouse track. Royce the 5'9", one of my favorite artists of all time. Huge shout out to Royce. He was on that track. Yellow Wolf was also on that track. And he shouted out Caterpillar, which Royce is also on. Royce's album is dope, by the way. If you guys haven't heard Book of Ryan, check that out. If you haven't heard Allegory, do yourself a favor. Go check that out as well. So we got two references right there, two discography references that he's doing. But also, he's a psychopathic killer like Daniel Wozniak, who killed two people. Hang on, too much to break down. Let's do it line by line.
You know, I probably act like I'm Daniel Wozniak. I'm a psychopath.
I act like I'm Daniel Wozniak. He killed that army veteran, didn't he? Because he was going to marry his fiance. He was broke. He didn't have a job at the time. Army vet was bragging about the money that he had stored, and then he killed him and tried to take his money. And he was an actor. He was an actor. That's right. Acting. Get the act line. So that's a double right there. Acting like a killer. Eminem. Oh, that's clever.
I told your boyfriend like I'll be back, but for all you know, I probably act like I'm Daniel Wozniak.
Told your boyfriend I'll be back. Because wasn't his fiance involved too? And like, she got indicted as well. And they were there at the time when he was killed. Like, I'll be back. And then there was a story because there was another witness. And then like, he went away with him and never came back with the army vet. I think he's playing off of that story.
You ran inside, told your boyfriend like I'll be back. But for all you know, I probably act like I'm Daniel Wozniak. I'm a psychopathic killer. I'm a caterpillar with the botanica.
Oh my God, I'm a caterpillar. Like, he's peeling cats. He's that crazy. He's psychopathic, he's saying. And he's like, it's almost like he fixed himself. Oh, I didn't mean to say that. I meant to say caterpillar. Come on.
No, I probably act like I'm Daniel Wozniak. I'm a psychopathic killer. I'm a caterpillar with the botanica bananas.
I just noticed that we had another new vocal with this beat switch, like the it's just hitting at the back of the mix, but that is a vocal as well that has also been taken and converted in frequency to instrumentation. That's dope.
I heard better vernacular. I'm a psychopathic killer. I'm a caterpillar with the botanica bananas. You never heard better vernacular coming after your scapula.
You never heard better vernacular. Again, him just dissecting words. He's using some fancy words here, Eminem. He's showing off his vernacular.
Killer, I'm a caterpillar with the botanica bananas. You never heard
the botanica bananas. It's like a botanist, right? Dealing with plants, except saying someone is bananas like someone is crazy, so he's playing off of like the bananas being a botanist, but also like he's bananas in the head, he's a psychopath.
I'm Daniel Wozniak, I'm a psychopathic killer. I'm a caterpillar with the botanica bananas. You never heard better vernacular coming after your scapula, for lack of a better word, Dracula, because I'm attacking the rapper.
Coming after your scapula, for lack of a better word, Dracula, scapula, that's your shoulder blade, right? What connects to it? Your neck. What does Dracula do? He comes for your neck.
I heard better vernacular coming after your scapula, for lack of a better word, Dracula, cause I'm attacking a rapper at the phrenic nerves. I'm a savage back to put the dagger in the back of competitor.
Attacking a rapper at the phrenic nerves. He's going into his biology bag on us again. All right, we got this. A phrenic nerve. I want to say the respiratory system. I want to say that controls the respiratory system. So basically, if he comes for your phrenic nerve, like, that's it. You're done. You're paralyzed after that.
Word Dracula, cause I'm attacking the rapper at the phrenic nerves. I'm a savage back to put the dagger in the back of competitors. Predator and scavenger, I am a carnivore and a baller.
Predator and scavenger, I'm a carnivore. He's a predator and a scavenger because he's a predator, he's hunting you. But also scavenger, like he's scavenging bodies, all these dead bodies that he's leaving in his wake. It's clever.
I'm a savage back to put the dagger in the back of competitors. Predator and scavenger, I am a carnivore and a baller.
What a crazy flow though. Crazy act scheme. Just a huge condensed rhyme scheme that he's just carrying through, man.
Vernacular coming after your scapula for lack of a better word. Dracula, cause I'm attacking the rapper at the phrenic nerves. I'm a savage back to put the dagger in the back of competitors. Predator and scavenger, I am a carnivore and a baller. You're at the dollar store. What the fuck you got a wallet for? Y'all are poor.
What are you doing at the dollar store? Why do you even have a wallet? You're at the dollar store, man. Come on, you can't afford that. You can't even afford anything at the dollar store. What you walking around with a wallet? We know there's no money in that.
Scavenger, I am a carnivore and a baller. You're at the dollar store. What the fuck you got a wallet for? Y'all are poor. I was living in squalor, but not no more. Now I'm the one they holler for. Fucking shit up like a dinosaur in a China store. Bitch, I'm number 5.
What?
Minus 4. Now count it by 10.
Wow. I was going to stop it, but you can never stop with him because he just goes bar after bar after bar. I just love the image of a dinosaur in a china shop just wrecking plates and everything. A little humor added. And then he goes 5 minus 4. What's 5 minus 4? 1. He's number 1, baby. That's clever.
A dinosaur in a china store, bitch. I'm number 5.
What?
Minus 4. Now count it by 10. Yeah, 15, 20, 25, 30. Yeah, get the money. Throw it in the furnace. Yeah,
I like this bounce.
Earn it just to burn it. Swag tripping from me. Yeah, I'm a. Yeah, I'm a. What? I'm a. What? I'm a. Yeah.
Take it out. This is a dope beat. Shout out to D. I got the dope. Wow, okay. Okay. Now I see why you guys wanted me to react to that. And like I suspected, that third verse was so much longer than the first two, and it was definitely more complex. And then he had that beat switch and that change up, man. That seems to be kind of a theme. Like, he's just not doing your typical song structure, and I like that. I like how he's just pushing, you know, what we understand songs to be. And just so much of that experimentation with that song. It's a great change up for the album. It's a change of pace from him. It's a different sort of style and sound. I like that. And honestly, I can't remember which one I talked about before. It was a Dr. Dre one, Guns Blazing. And I said, I don't see that one as kind of a standalone single. This one, though, because of the bounce and because of how well written that hook is, I don't know, it's got that vibe, man. It could definitely be played like in a club. It's got a little bit of that single value if you wanted to take it there. But at the same time, it just serves well from the macro perspective on the album for giving the fans something different and just keeping things moving and interesting. And as always, it comes with the wordplay, comes with the delivery, the craziness, man. It's Eminem. He's a master at what he does. Eminem? You were Knox Hill certified. So hope you guys liked today's video. If you did, be sure to smash that like button. I am losing my voice. I am getting sick. Yes, I know I need to take care of myself, but we have more Eminem to get through. So stick with me, guys. Hit that subscribe button right now. Notifications on. Do me that favor. I love you, and I'll catch you in the next vid. I'm out.